Hello, my name is Scott Wood. I was born and raised in Tishomingo. I live there currently with my wife Ashley. I have three daughters. My oldest daughter is, she's 20. I have a little daughter, Mila, she's 13, and a young daughter, Cheyenne, she's 6. I own two businesses there in Tishomingo, Wood Chiropractic Clinic, which I'm a doctor of chiropractic, and also Texoma Physical Therapy and Rehab. Texoma Physical Therapy and Rehab has been established for about three, almost 4 years. We established that facility due to the need for physical therapy in our community. All the doctors in the area didn't have anywhere to send their physical therapy patients. When they did, they had to send them 30 to 40 miles away, which if you know anything about physical therapy, usually you're going 2 to 3 times a week, usually maybe 6, 8, sometimes 12 weeks. And that's just not practical for a lot of the patients. So we established that clinic. It has become a great asset for the community and also the doctors. I have worked around Indian Health Service, Chickasaw Nation for several years throughout my college years. My dad has been associated with Indian Health Service and Chickasaw Nation for a total of about 38 years. 19 years with Indian Health Service, 19 years with Chickasaw Nation. And he has served Indian people well. He has served Chickasaw people well. And that's why I'm here today. I'm here today to serve Chickasaw people, or I wouldn't be in this position on that right now. And I feel like there's a great need to serve Chickasaw people. I want to see Chickasaw people do well. I want to see them thrive. And that's the same way I do with patients in my practice. I want to see them do well. I want to see them get better. If they're not getting better, then I feel like I'm doing something wrong. A couple things I want to talk about is maybe we'll start with like educational programs. Educational programs have been great. There's a lot of good programs out there. There's a lot of money available for students. I use these educational programs to get 2 bachelor's degrees and get my doctorate degree. But during the time when I did those, tuition and books were a lot cheaper. So the funding that we got from, or I got from Chickasaw Nation really served me well. But these days, the universities, some of the tuition increases are just unbelievable. And the funding that you see that some of the Chickasaw students are getting is just not comparable to what some of the tuition costs are. For example, we'll give you this. Let's take OU for example. OU's tuition runs maybe $9,000 to $10,000 a semester. Maybe in the general fund through higher ed, we get maybe $2,750, $2,700. Now I know there's scholarships available, things like that, and you can take student loans out. That's a big gap right there. That's a large gap. If you go to Murray State College, the tuition for a semester might cost you about $2,500, and Chickasaw Nation funds probably around $2,000, I believe. So that's a smaller gap. And I think when we have students that get into OU, for example, colleges like Stanford or Vanderbilt, some of the higher end colleges and universities, I think we need to close that gap a little bit more. I think the $2,750 or almost $3,000 just don't cut it. I think we need to reward those students for their accomplishments for getting in those facilities. So it's almost imperative we do that, because I mean that's an honor for them to be at those type of universities. Also, we look at the books. For those. OU, I think, runs around $500 to $600 a semester for books, usually for students. Murray State College is about $300 to $400 per semester for students. And I think the book funding is maybe around $300. And so there's a big gap between the OU funding and what the student actually receives, not much between like Murray State College and what they receive. So I'd like to see those get closer together for students. If we look at another thing that's very important is our elders. You know, our elders are one of our greatest assets. I mean, their longevity to Chickasaw Nation is very vital to us. I mean, you know, for the knowledge and wisdom. Some of the things that we need to look at is long-term care facilities, also assisted living, and our own Chickasaw-based home health. I'm real healthcare oriented, so that's my main goals right there that I'd like to see supported. You know, we have no long-term care facilities, very important. You know, we need several throughout the boundaries of Chickasaw Nation would be great. We need the assisted living. We need that home health. And these long-term care facilities, you know, they can be self-supported. They can make their own money. They could also house not only Chickasaw or not only Indian people, but non-Indian, and be very lucrative. I mean, it's very doable. Same thing with the home health. The home health is something vital that I think we need. I think it would be a great asset to Chickasaw Nation. And home health these days make money. So it's self-supportive. It's something that can support itself. And I think we need these because we need to, you know, we have the hospitals, we have the clinics, things of that nature, but we're not finishing the care. We're not looking out for our elders when they get to that certain point in their life. Spoke with one of the elders here last week, she's almost 90, and she told me if we had an assisted living that was nice, she said she would go there because she lives alone, and so she depends on someone to take care of her, someone to stop by all the time. And but she said, we had the Chickasaw,